This week on the Extreme Crappie Angler.
Dude. That is huge. Let me get the...
Find the right clump, catch the right crappie.
There we go.
Good one too, eh?
Oh yeah, buddy.
Look at that single pole, killer. Okay. Eh?
That's killer, dude. That's what I'm talking about.
You like crappie fishing, eh?
Oh. I'm Carl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way, visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. The Extreme Crappie Angler is presented by B&M Poles, leader in crappie, Strike King Lure Company, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor.
Big thick clump right there. One on one with the fish right in front of you.
There we go.
Good one too, eh?
Oh yeah, buddy.
Look at that single pole killer. Eh?
That's killer, dude. That's what I'm talking about.
You like crappie fishing, eh?
Yeah.
Let the long rod bit challenge, eh?
You gotta get used to it.
Show him how deep he took that thing. Look at that.
Like that. Oh, man.
An afternoon of single poling with B&M. I got the ultralight. He's got the, the brush buster.
Oh, yeah.
And look what he's busting. Crappies with the slab slanger. This afternoon, it's all about single poling, hunting them down, just like bass, one at a time.
What a way to start.
Let's put them in the box, huh?
Yeah.
Look at the clumps down there. Find the right clump, catch the right crappie. Some are just holding it. That one's not holding. Whoa. It's incredible, the sensitivity of the rod and everything else, and yet they just come up to it, boom, and hold it. Wow. But for this kind of technique, I'll be honest, the sun helps tenfold. Because you can see the little edges, sometimes the stumps, something in the water, a clump, something that they can relate to and hold to. So right now we're just fishing with faith, pushing it into the old, actually their new little red lily pads, and the water is really high right now, so the pads are just below the surface, and they're just holding that kind of stuff so they have somewhere they can spawn. We're just pitching it out, holding it, holding the line out here, pitching out, letting it go down. And I'd say it's about 3 feet of water, holding it down about 2.5. I'm right like that, lifting up and catching a fish. Let me try that again, see if I can catch a fish. So putting it out, I did. I put it down like that, hold it there like that, just shake a little bit. This hand, I can feel the sensitivity. And with this hand, I got right there, underneath the reel seat, the blank coming through, I feel anything that touches it, as long as they give me a little boop, not just holding it. Let's keep going. Oh my God, dude. You see the size of this gray thing.
Oh, buddy.
Look. Rods. You just gotta have fun, have the poles out, and just search, destroy. Look how he's got it. Look at that. Like, I mean, this is so much fun, man. What a way to catch them. Single poling. Hunting. He's not big enough for us to eat. Of course, we're gonna let him go. But look at the colors, eh? Beautiful crappies. Now this, if you haven't done it before, you gotta do it, man. Single poling. You think, what was single poling? It's picking up your stick. This is a 12 footer. And so altogether, you figure I got about 14 feet of line out. So that's 24 feet of water or 24 feet of space I can cover. And I use my hand, pull the bait out like this, and I can just drop it into holes and just hold it in the spot. Hold it in the spot. Wait for that dark shadow, sometimes the bump. And with these rods, see that right there? The blank's coming through, my finger's there. There's no way I'm not gonna feel that. It's like electricity. Ding! He's got it. Sometimes you see the bait disappear. Ding! Once you set, and that bait goes up like this, just like this, see?
Yep.
Like that, it's done. Let's keep going and find some real big ones. Sometimes they're out here on the branch outside where there's even lily pads. You're on the tree and you think they should all be there, and the buggers are sitting on the outside edges of the branches by the lily pads. That's why you gotta dissect it all. That 12-foot pole, you can do it all.
This is a clump, but there's clumps here again. These weeds. Oh yeah! There's one,
I saw that one.
Oh yeah. That's
Look at
fun.
Him.
Look at that. I'm getting the hang of this now.
Hey, you like that, eh?
Yeah, watch a little bit better than you, Coach. Watch this. That's at my height.
Well, I have the real bottom feet. I don't have that actual handle of the rod. I can't do that.
Beautiful fish. And you seen him just eat it.
Lime truce, I think this is.
Leprechaun green.
Yeah. Lucky leprechaun?
Yeah.
Is it lucky charm?
No.
Magically delicious.
Where's me? Charms?
You like that?
This is when the fishing gets really good.